What's up, YouTube family? It's your boy, Mr. Knock One Down, and I'm back at it today. Today I'm gonna be in the kitchen cooking some oxtails. Yeah, that's right. I'm gonna be cooking down some oxtails, and I think I'm gonna cook them Jamaican style. So y'all stay tuned for that. Stick around. Until then, I gotta clean out my fireplace. It's kind of cold and windy here in Houston, and I'm gonna clean my fireplace out. I've been burning wood left and right, just like the ambience of it, the smell of it. And just to be able to look into the fireplace and see the flames kicking, it's relaxing. So y'all stay tuned while I clean my fireplace out, and then I wash up and take it to the kitchen. Burning pretty good here. I got quite a bit of ashes in here. So beautiful ambiance. Alright, I'm getting ready to cut up my bell peppers, my onions, my habanero. Yeah, when I'm done with that, I'll season my wash and season my oxtails, put them in the pot. But after I saute the vegetables down, so I'll just stick around and get this set up. You see, I mean, put, if it fall off my cutting board onto my counter, still in good shape. As I was saying earlier, you want a clean surface, so if something falls off my cutting board, I can, you know, the countertop has been cleaned, so I can still utilize that vegetable or whatnot. So, got the onion cut up. Peppers now. calls for 3 to 4 large carrots, peeled and cut. I just bought some of the small carrots, and that's what I'm gonna add to the mix. All right, got that cut up. I'm gonna move on to my cleaning up the oxtails. All right, we got the oxtails washed up and in a bowl. I'm gonna get ready to season these bad boys up. Start out with about 3 tablespoons of W sauce. Teaspoon of allspice. I went to the grocery store and forgot to get my the ground. I got the little pebbles, so it worked just fine. Put a teaspoon and a half of salt. You don't want put too much salt. You can always come back in the end and taste test it. Add a little bit then. A little teaspoon of black pepper. I'm coming here with some of my jerk marinade. Now we're going to massage this good. Roll my sleeve up. I took red beans and rice on yesterday, so I didn't really make any meat other than the sausage that was in the red bean and rice. So I'm doing these oxtails today, and I put my greens in the crock pot. That is how you want to mix that up real good. All right, now I got my pot on the up, heating up with olive oil in there. We're gonna sear these oxtails. Once I sear them, I'll take them out and put more in there until I'm done, and then we'll saute the vegetables down. Fun begin. Y'all like to hear that sizzle. What you want them to look like? Flip them over. Almost done with the browning them. In the meantime, while those oxtails are browning, I'm over here cutting the greens up. Fresh out of my buddy garden there. My winemaking buddy brought me this over yesterday when I gave him a catfish. You can see how big the leaves are on these rascals. I think he said they were mustard greens. Yep. Mustard greens. Salt and vinegar to this water. This won't be a lot of greens, but no one eats them in the house with me, so whatever I don't eat, like always, I freeze it. And then later days and time, when I have a taste for pig feet or greens or red beans, just go to the deep freeze and voila. You don't have to go through all of this again. So I always try to cook enough for later. Let those soak a little bit. Cut up my jalapeno for my greens while I wait. Alright, my second washing of those greens there. Just gonna bring my crock over here. So when I'm done straining them. All right, I got the onion sauteed down. Go ahead and add the oxtails back to it. Put my scotch bonnet pepper, bell peppers in here. My carrots. My bay leaves in there. I'm doing about two of them. Small one. Thyme. and 2 tablespoons of ketchup. Tablespoon of apple cider vinegar. Maybe a little bit more Worcestershire sauce. Adobe. Top it off with the beef broth. And I can sit back and let this do its thing. Didn't quite cover it up, so. That's what I want. Now I'm gonna let this thing cook for about 2 to 3 hours. I'm gonna get it up to a ball and then I'll cut it down to medium low. That'll do a thing. Hey y'all, stick around. Don't go anywhere. I'm finished seasoning these greens up. I'm gonna add some smoked turkey butts to them. Finish seasoning them up. Then I'm gonna go sit down for a minute and let this food do what it do. Stay tuned. All right, I got my greens finished. Got them seasoned up. Smoked turkey butts. I'm gonna let them ride. All right, I'm gonna focus my attention now to my cornbread. And 1 egg, 1/3 cup of milk, 1/3 cup of milk, and mix it up. Some of my jiffy, one of my favorite cornbreads. I like the little sweet taste it has. I'm gonna stir this real good. I already greased my muffin pan. Got my oven on 350. Letting it preheat. You don't want to fill it all the way up because it's going to rise. Like I might be in trouble. Might have to. Do another box here. All right, got my pan filled all the way up, and what I had left over, I just put it in my little small cast iron skillet, so it won't go to waste, and we'll make a little cornbread out of it. Just waiting on my oven to hit 350. It's at 335 right now. So we almost there. I'm ready to take a break and chill. I want to thank you guys once again for tuning in on this episode of Chasing Tails. Well, I'm showing you guys how to cook Caribbean style jerk, oxtails, and mustard greens with smoked turkey butt and cornbread. Like I said, I did my red beans and rice on yesterday. The kids won't eat the cornbread. I mean, they won't eat the greens, but as always, I just freeze my stuff. And when I want something, I just thaw it out and I got it. I'm gonna set my timer for about 30 minutes, and I'll check those muffins, cornbread muffins, in about 30 minutes and get back with you guys. Got that cornbread finish. Just waiting on them oxtails. Crockpot greens look good. Let's check in on these oxtails and do this tender test. Stick my fork in them and, oh yeah, falling off the bone. I'm gonna cut that out. Go ahead and plate me some up. I'll let it cook a little longer, maybe about 10 minutes, another 5 minutes or so. Kind of let those. Those green scallions, green onions, work down a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and dip me out. Get my fork so I don't get any of those green onions, or minimize getting them. Ooh. Kind of breaking up there. Oops. So close. Let's see if I can get me two of them out of there. There we go. Find me a little small one. All right, people, I'm gonna cut me a little piece of this cornbread. And you didn't see these red beans and rice being cooked today because they were cooked on yesterday. And warmed up today. All right, YouTube. Got it plated up here. Jiffy cornbread. I know I won't be able to eat all of this. I try to make it small, but it's gonna take some getting used to. Now, Jiffy cornbread, red beans and rice, and oxtail. Plastic fork, you see how I'm cutting it? I mean, it's tender. That's hidden. Get a little bit of this. Until next time, it's your boy, Mr. Knock One Down. Another episode of Chasing Tails Outdoors in the Kitchen. Peace. Once the greens are done, they nice and tender. Got some on my plate. I'm gonna do a little taste testing. Got some of these mustards and cornbread on my plate. A couple of oxtails. A couple of carrots. A few carrots on there. Let's taste these mustard greens. Chase it with some oxtails.